Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear viewers, today we will design multi-storied building in ETABS as per IS code. That means Indian standard. What we will see in this tutorial? Modeling a multi-storied building with basement, with ramp, underground water tank, also overhead water tank. Applying loads including soil pressure on basement wall, water pressure on water tanks. Applying live loads, seismic loads and wind loads as per IS code with explanation. Assigning proper diaphragm. Null line warning resolving with null beam. Analysis and design of the structure. So let's start. Storied residential building in ETABS V18. We will design this structure as per IS code, that means Indian standard. Here I have arranged required data for our design, and we will apply also soil pressure in basement wall. Here underground water tank, here we will apply water pressure. We will model ramp. Then this is ground floor, first floor to ninth floor. This one terraced roof plan. Here overhead water tank bottom. Here overhead water tank top. So this structure we will model in ETABS. Then we will do analysis and design as per IS code. So let's start. Open ETABS program, click on new model, metric SI, Indian, concrete design code IS 456-2000. So click on OK. Number of grid we will check along X direction 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and along Y direction 9, 11 and 9. So 11, 9. Spacing we can provide common spacing like 4.4. Then we will edit and Y direction. We can provide 5. Number of story. 13 number of stories. Typical story height here 3.5 meter. 3.5 meter bottom story height, this one minus 3.5, and ground floor plus 0.2. that means the floor height will be 3.5 and here 0.2, 3.7 meter. Click on OK. Now we will modify our grid. Right click here, modify or show grid system, display grid data as spacing. Here we will check the grid spacing. Here I am using two monitor, so one I will take in another monitor. From there I will see the distance and I will write here 3.75 3.25. Now click on OK. We can edit our story data also. Here we can make it basement roof, GF roof. Click on OK. OK. Now we will go to basement roof. We will save this model. IS code design using IS code. Now we will define material properties. Add new India concrete. We will use M30 grade for this multi-storied building. Click on OK. Add new material. Rebar. We will use rebar grade 415 MPa. Click on OK. 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 Now go to define section properties. Here we can delete these sections. Okay. Now add new properties. Concrete rectangular. We will define some column properties like C 40 by 40. Concrete strength M30. 400 millimeter. Modify show rebar. Here clear cover. We will see. In most of the general cases, the minimum values of clear cover are 50 millimeter for foundation, 40 millimeter for column, 25 millimeter for beam, 25 millimeter for shear wall, 15 millimeter for slab and stair. For nominal cover requirements based on exposure conditions and fire resistance, we can go through chart below as per IS code 456-2000. Here this is the chart. Exposure condition and here nominal cover. Here fire resistance time in hour 0.5 hour, 1 hour, 1.5 hour. Here beam, slab, rib, column. We will use 40 millimeter for columns, 40 millimeter grade, rebar grade 415 MPa. Click on OK. And property modifiers as per our code factors will be, here we can see column 0.7 for this one. For design, for serviceability check, it will be 1.0. JI2 I3 0.7. here torsional constant J 0.7, I2 0.7, I3 0.7. Okay, click on OK. OK. Now this one we can delete. Add copy of property so that we don't need to modify these modifiers every time, and we don't need to change the rebar properties and covering every time. We will use add copy of property to save our time. So here C 40 by 50, depth 500. Click on OK. Now we will define our beam. Add new properties. Beam. Here beam 25 by 40, 400 250. Here this one beam cover to longitudinal rebar group centroid. So group centroid, that means top bar centroid. Here beam cover 25 millimeter. So 25 millimeter plus, if we use 16 millimeter diabar or 20 millimeter diabar, 20 center of the 20 millimeter diabar is 10 millimeter plus 25 millimeter, that means 35 millimeter. 35 millimeter. Okay, then rebar properties 415 MPa, click on OK. Stiffness modifier here for beam, this one 0.35 for design, for serviceability check 0.5. So for design 0.35, click on OK. Okay. Here we need to change our concrete properties M30, click on OK. M30, click on OK. Now add copy of properties, next 25 by 60, 600, click on OK. So beam and column section properties we have defined, click on OK. We will go for wall section, modify wall 40 cm, that means 400 mm, M30, then go to modifiers, modify or show. Here we will see for shear wall F22, F12, M11, M22, M12, all will be 0.7. For serviceability check, it will be 1. So we will go to this one, 0.7. F22 to M12. You can check my previous tutorial. There I have discussed about property or stiffness modification factors in ETABS. You can search by the name stiffness modification factor in ETABS in YouTube. You will get that tutorial. Click on OK. Okay. Now add copy of property. Wall 25. 250 mm, click on OK. Okay. Now define slab, modify. Here first we will model ram 30 25 cm 250. Modifiers will be for slab M1, M2, M12, 0.25, click on OK. Okay. Now we will model our basement wall. Go to wall, so click on this. Now here we can see there is underground water tank, this portion. We will use same 40 cm wall, G grid from here, here to here. Now here we can model our columns. Go to column. See 40 by 40 here, here, here. See 40 by 50. We will use here A, C, D, E, G. I am taking this plan in another screen so that I can model faster. Now we will model our shear wall. Go to wall here, W25. Here I will not use auto pier, I will select no. We will take point 0.35 meter distance, that means 35 centimeter distance. Draw joint object 350 millimeter, as it is millimeter. So from here like this, and positive 350, like this. Now go to wall, okay. Now we can make it invisible so that joint object will not disturb our visibility. Now we will add our ramp. Go to draw floor option, select the ramp, then go to basement, go to up, right click. Now here we can provide beam for the starting of the ramp. Go to beam 30 by 50. I will draw on beam from here to here. Then I'll break the frames, apply. Okay, now from this side we will replicate the beam from here to here. Okay, now we will draw our supporting beam. Okay, now we can delete the side beams. Now this column we can merge to make it single member, make it single column. Now we will model our basement roof beam and slab. We can draw like this 25 by 60 beam, or we can use this one also for quick draw frame, 25 by 60. This one. So modeling of beam finished. Now we will merge the beams which are separated for intermediate grids. Merge this one. Now we will model our slab, quick draw slab. floor slab S175. Here in this way we can model, or we can do it at the same time like this. Now delete this portion as there is ramp. Now in this portion here will be opening. Now this one will be stair portion. So this one we will keep, we will make it stair 20. This one we will delete. This one we can break 1/2 area. Okay, now this one delete. Can draw dimension line here to here, this 0.95. But we need here 1.2 meter. Okay, so select this one, this 2 point, then 0.25. We will move it to along. We will move it along y direction like this. Now this one we will change to stair 20. Then this one we will move it to 3.7 meter floor height divided by 2, that means 1.85 meter minus 2, move it along negative z direction, apply. Okay, now here you can see in 3D view this is done. Now this one we will break into 2/1 parts, apply. This one also like this. Now here we can select the beam columns and the elements to model the stair easily. Right click, here right click, then show selected objects only. Here you can remove our grid, and from here we can remove our horizon. These two we can replicate at history. Base, apply. Okay. Now from here, stair, like this. So this one remove. These 2 point assign, restrain like this, and this one also. Here we draw beam from the basement to start the stair. Okay, we can show all object. Okay, now we will go to support condition. We will select the supports here. We need to be careful so that here we will not select the joints to provide support. Provide fixed support, click on apply. Now for this underground water tank there is opening as per our plan. This opening size is 1.5 by 1.5 meter. Maybe this is for manhole. So we will replicate this one. We will model in accurate position 0.5 meter, 0.5 meter. Click on apply. Then we will draw another beam here. Replicate minus same 0.5. Click on apply. This one will replicate minus 1.5. Replicate. Apply. Yes. Now this 4 beam we can break. Here. Opening this point to this point. Now we can remove these reference beams. Another 3 openings are there. So this basement floor plan finished. Select the floor. We will apply floor finish 1.5 kN per square meter. Dead load 1.5 kN per meter square. Or we can define separate load pattern to assign this one. So we can go for that one also. Define load pattern, add, and this one for partition wall, add. Click on OK. Now assign floor finish 1.5 kN per meter square. Click on apply. Yes. Partition wall load we will assign as line load, so we will not go for that one. Live load we will assign. Here we can see live load chart as per IS code for different occupancies. We will use for residential building 2 kN per meter square, for corridor and stair 3 kN per square meter. So live load 2 kN per meter square, and this corridor 3, and for stair also 3. Here for ramp, for ramp we can check here garage floors or vehicles not exceeding 4 tons gross weight, so we can provide this one 5 kN per meter square. 5. Apply. Now we will apply soil pressure to our basement wall. Select the walls. Now we have to define soil pressure load pattern. SP soil pressure as live load. Add. Click on OK. Now go to assign shell load non-uniform here. In previous tutorial I have discussed how this formula is working for soil pressure and surface pressure. and this for water pressure. Here we will provide soil unit weight, surcharge load. Here we will consider 10 kN per meter square. Height of water, not now. We are going for soil, height of side soil 3.5 meter. Angle of soil friction. We have to take this one from soil report, 30 degree here I am considering. Now for soil and surcharge pressure, this is coming. D is coming 26, C is coming minus 6. Okay, 26 minus 6. Okay, this one soil pressure and this one will be local 3-axis. Click on apply. Here we can see local 3-axis. Shear local axis. So this blue one, axis 3. This blue one, all are outward direction. As we have assigned our pressure along this direction, so we need to reverse this direction from the load gauge. Go to load gauge, soil pressure, modify this one. Scale factor will be minus 1. Click on OK. OK. Now for water tank plan, go to gauge. Here this portion is our water tank. Here we will define another slab. Add copy of property, WT, bottom slab 30 cm 300. This one will be provided at the foundation top level. So click on OK. OK. Water tank bottom like this. Water pressure define, load pattern, water pressure live, add, click on OK. Now go to shell uniform load, water pressure. Here we will calculate this one. The length, here it is 9.5 meter, 4.6 meter, 9.5, 4.6. Here underground water tank. For example, here in this residential building, there is 3 flat, number of story 10 per person. Person per flat, it is considered 6 person. Water required per person 225 liter per capita per day. Tank L, here tank length, here 9.5 into 3.28. to convert it into feet, 31.16, and D 4.6 into 3.28. this one we can make it double by 2, this liter for 2 days, then this area is required. So this length, this width, and this is the height required. Free board, that means 1 feet. Tank height required 8 feet. We will check what we have provided, 3.7 into 3.28, so 12 feet is our height. Here we can check with 3 days, 11 feet required. Here our height is 12 feet, so this is okay. So from here, providing the tank length and width, we can calculate the required height of the tank. Freeboard 1 feet, tank height required 11 feet, in meter, it will be less than 3.7 meter. So it is okay, as we have provided the height here. Now water pressure will be maximum height of water. Here we can provide 12 by 3.28 meter, 12 feet we are considering. So 3.65 meter we will consider. Here pressure is coming 36.5 kN per meter square. Here 36.5 kN per meter square. Click on OK. Here for water pressure we have to separate in this basement wall. Divide this one by 2x1 area. Here it is coming like this. So this one we will select, this one we will select, and we will move from here to here up to that water tank position. Okay, in this one we will apply our water pressure. This one, from here we can select this one, then show selected object. This one, and this one. For this portion also we need to divide this area. So this one break 2 into 1, this one remove. Now select this point and this point, then move, pick 2 points from here to here like this. So now select this wall for applying water pressure. Go to assign, now uniform water pressure local axis 3. We will check the local axis later. Now here we will calculate the water pressure. Unit weight of water 10 kN per meter cube, and height of water here 3.65 will provide. Okay, now from here we can check D 36.5, C minus 10. 36.5 minus 10. Click on apply. Okay, now here we can check our local axis. This direction, this outer, all are outward direction. So this is okay. Okay, now local axis this. So this is our basement floor level. Now we will go for next floor. Now we will select this portion, replicate two story ground floor roof. Click on apply. Now here we have got intermediate slab also for landing. This one we will delete. We will select our stair landing, this one for our ground floor roof. Okay, So for landing level, we need to provide one beam 25 by 50. Like this. Okay. So this is our ground floor roof. In ground floor roof, we have to provide some cantilever slabs. Here, this one will provide 25 by 50 or 25 by 60. Here in down floor there was water tank wall, so there no need this beam. And here in this floor there is another opening, so we will provide that one. This one we will copy. Ground floor roof. Okay, this opening we will move from this point to this point. This point to this point. Okay. This one we can move pick to point from here to here. Now we will see our cantilever portion. This is the slab outline, so accordingly we will model our ground floor roof. This one we will delete. Another thing, we have to model wall load. We will check partition wall load here. If we provide 230 mm wall width and this is having 18.5 kN per meter cube unit weight, brick work unit weight, and if the wall height is 3 m, then this is the loading for wall. Here our floor is 3.5 m. We are considering 50 cm for beam depth, so balance is 3 m. We will provide this one as wall load. To apply the wall load, we will model non line. Now go to select object type, null line, select this one. Now click on apply. 12.765, that means 12.8. click on apply. So this is our wall load on top of the basement wall. Okay, now go to ground floor roof. Here we will model our cantilever portions. This one 1 m by 4.4 m. This one replicate. You can apply. Then here we can apply. We can model S175 cantilevers. Here this portion from grid 0.8 m. This distance 1.5 minus 0.8 like this. Then here we can zero minus 1.5, this one positive 1.5. Model this one is 175. Now we can delete this one. In this way we will finish this floor modeling. So we have modeled our cantilever portions. Now here we need to cut this slab to provide this portion. This is our slab outline. So here we will check from this grid line to this 0.6, this to this 2.3, from here to here 0.5. In this way we will draw some lines. This one we will offset 2.3 meter, or we can make it move 0 minus 2.3, then this portion offset 0.6, here we have got same. We can merge this to slab. Now we can apply our loading, floor load, in this level also, so that it will select only XY plan from the model. Now we can apply floor finish 1.5, click apply, then previous selection, live load 2 kN per meter square, this one, partition off, we will provide line load. Before that we will check our stair, this portion will be 3, this corridor portion also will be 3. Okay, these cantilever portions, these are provided for balcony as per IS code chart from here. Here you can see balcony is 3 kN per meter square. So for balcony we will provide 3 kN per meter square. Okay, now for partition wall, for example here we have half partition wall. So we will select these null lines to apply the wall load. Here if it is, if the height is half or 75%, then it will be 2 meter. 8.51. So 8.5 we can apply partition wall 8.5. Select the peripheral beams to apply full wall load. And in this portion also, and here full wall load 12.8. Now for internal walls we can model null line. For example, if here is wall, here wall, here wall, here this portion wall, then go to draw, snap option, perpendicular, apply like this. Now this wall, this wall, this, this, this wall, this wall we will select, and here we will consider on top of this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam. Here we have applied already this, this beam. We have selected these lines where there is no beam but there is wall. We have modeled null line. Now we will apply wall load 12.8 kN/m. Now we can see this perspective view like this. We can see the wall loads we have applied. For staircase we can apply load half half, because this beam will take half of this load. So these two we can divide into two parts. So 12.8 divided by 2, 6.4. Landing beam 6.4 kN/m, this one 6.4 kN/m of, because the wall height is half of the floor height. So this floor we have finished. Now we can replicate this story up to 9th floor roof, that means this 9F roof. So select this one, ground floor roof, then from here to 9F roof, click on apply. Now we can go to 9th floor roof. Here we will see next floor terrace floor roof like this. This height is 3.2 m. So go to modify story, here terrace floor roof. Here terrace floor roof 3.2 m, and overhead water tank top, this one 2.5 m. Click on OK. Now this one we can replicate to story, terrace floor roof and overhead water tank. Okay. Now from here go to terrace floor roof. You will see here up to D2 J grid we are having this floor, and here in this portion only we are having slab with some opening for architectural design, no beams here. So D up to D, we will delete this portion. We have selected, then we will apply this parapet wall load. From here if the wall load is 1.5 m, then we will calculate 0.23 multiplied by 18.5 multiplied by 6.38, that means 6.4 kN per meter square per meter in apply. Now here this portion we can divide so that we can apply actual loading 0 here, then we can merge this beam. See here, now this portion 0, this portion 6.4. Now as this is terrace floor roof, so we have edited this loading in this floor. Now we will select this one story. Here we have edited our loads in override water tank top. So what we will do, we will delete this level, then we will replicate this level to story terrace floor roof. Now another thing we have to check, we will go to first floor roof. Here fixtures are not replicated, so go to ground floor roof, select the stairs, then replicate first floor roof to terrace floor roof. Now we will go to overhead water tank top. Here in this portion we will have water tank load. Here we will calculate the length 6 meter, width 4.5 meter, length 6, 4.5, height of water, here this one 2.5 meter height. We are taking full height for this water tank. Freeboard 1 feet, that means we can consider 0.5 meter. Here we can type 2.5 minus slab thickness 0.15, water tank top slab thickness minus 1 feet freeboard 1 divided by 3.28 feet, 2.04, that means 2 meter, 20 kN per meter square water tank load. Here water pressure 20 kN per meter square, and here we can model wall also. This portion 25, from here we can delete the beams. You can see from 3D view this overhead water tank, this wall, this one, this one, this one. I have water pressure, so we will apply water pressure. Assign shell non-uniform. Here water pressure, here height of water 2 meter, then it is coming 20 minus 10 20 c minus 10. Click on apply. Okay, now we can see the local axis, local axis 3. We can select this walls only, and we can show selected object only. This local axis 3, outward direction button, this one and this one inward direction. Show all object. Now from here we will select this one and this one. We will choose all history, then this one. Now we will see show selected object only. Show local axis. We will go to edit shell, reverse all local 3 axis outside direction. Now click on all history, show all object like this. Okay, so this is done. Now here we will delete this portion. Now this portion we will model stair top slab. And this one lift floor, this one lift core top slab. Okay, this one will be deleted. In this area we will provide machine load, live load. Here in IS code we have got one reference, that is work areas with machinery equipments, light duty 5, medium duty 7, heavy duty 10. And here if we have the machine equipment load, then we can divide that load by the area to get UDL. If there is no data for machine load, we can use heavy duty 10 kN per meter square for lift machine weight. So this one 10, click on apply. To provide this machine rooftop floor, we will go to modify this one, add story 2.5 meter, click on OK. Machine room top, MR top, machine room top. Here we will delete this portion, we will delete this portion, only this portion we will keep for machine room top. In this case we can remove this portion and this portion. As this is machine rooftop, so we will edit the live load 2 kN per meter square. So here we can provide 0, no wall. Okay, now here we can provide opening for, here you can see this grid 0.5, then spacing, 6 meter, 0.6 meter, 0.6 meter. Thank you. okay. Here this one we can delete if it is not available in architectural plan. If it is available in architectural plan, then we have to provide. I am deleting this one. Okay, so now our model is finished.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.